Hey seniors, it's Mr. Engel and our senior class sponsor, Ms. Riley.
Hello.
We have a special message for you, some important things. Ms. Riley, first, just want to say thank you for all you're doing to make sure our seniors have a great spring semester. And we're getting close. Graduation's around the corner, prom, lots of important dates. And we want everyone to experience all the fun that a senior should have in the spring. However, there's some really important things I want you to know. Two things that I want to start before Ms. Riley gets in. One is attendance recovery. As a 9th, 10th, and 11th grader, you were able to do spring semester attendance recovery, you know, at the start of the following school year or in the summer, but it was after the last day of school. Well, if you're a senior and you want to participate in our graduation that happens at the end of May, you have to have all your attendance and all your grades completed by the last day of school. There isn't any time after school to do that. People ask me all the time, well, Mr. Engel, can't we just walk and then we'll finish it in the summer? No, the graduation ceremony is a privilege that is only granted to those people who have earned both their attendance credit and their grade credit. So you have to be really careful of that. Those of you banking on attendance recovery into the spring, well, that recovery may not happen until the summer or fall. And that means you won't get to graduate and walk across the stage and be a part of that ceremony. Two things happen, right? Like, only people receiving their diploma get to participate in the graduation ceremony. So if you haven't met your credits, haven't met your attendance, you're not going to get to be a part of that ceremony. Moving forward, we really want to see everyone graduate. We really want to see everyone participate. But I want you to be mindful of your grades, your attendance, and these important dates that Ms. Riley's going to talk about in regards to getting everything, because some of those things are outside of the control of Ms. Riley and I. Some of them are up to the companies that we're working with, like Herf Jones, getting your cap and gown. So please pay close attention. Please make sure you share this video with your parents, and please make sure you pay special attention to these dates. Ms. Riley.
Yes, sir. So we have a lot of things going on in the spring semester. Want to touch on graduation first. Graduation is June 1st. We will be at Dickey's Arena at 8 o'clock at night. We are the last of three graduations that day. As we get closer, we'll get more information to everybody, but something I get, I'm asked almost daily, there are no tickets for graduation. You do not have a certain number of family members or friends that you can bring to graduation. It's Dickey's Arena. It's huge. We could fill up the entire stadium if we wanted to.
It's beautiful.
It is.
We're very blessed to be able to have such a wonderful facility to call our graduation home.
What you do need to be aware of is that there may actually be a parking fee at Dickey's Arena. Last year the district was able to have someone pay that for us, but we're not guaranteed this year that that's going to happen. So just so you, if you're planning, you know that parking is $20 a car at Dickey's Arena, just in case that happens.
And I know that Fort Worth leadership is working towards trying to find a solution to that. But in case they don't, we always want to plan worst case scenario. So we want to give you as much information as we know ahead of time. Again, we're hopeful that there'll be other alternatives to a $20 a car or $20 per car fee. However, if not, by giving it to you early, we hope that you can find a workable solution.
Okay. So cap and gowns. The attire for that day is the cap, the gown, the stole, and the tassel. Right now, it's $45 with Herf Jones. March 1st, that goes up, and it will go up at least $20. So cap and gowns really need to be purchased before March 1st. Right now, we only have about 70 seniors that have done that. So we want to make sure that everybody gets what they need at a reasonable price when they don't have to pay extras for service fees and whatnot. So March 1st is that deadline.
Yeah, and the earlier you pay, the more convenient it's going to be for you as regards to whether it's brought to you here at school. The later you pay, you may have to go and pick it up from them. So it's not only the additional cost, but then gas money and time out of your day. So go ahead and knock this out early. Go ahead and get these things. If you have questions, we're here to help. But don't wait to the last minute. The last minute is going to cost you more, and it's going to cost you time and energy because it's not going to be as easily made available to you as well.
Correct. Prom. I know that's a big thing for seniors, and right now prom is on April 28th. We are having it a little bit early this year, and yes, that is a Friday night. We have to first stress they have to come to school that day because that is an attendance day.
Absolutely.
Prom is 7:30 to 11:30. Tickets are $70 a piece, and they will be on sale April 3rd through the 7th. So as we get closer to that, I'll get the seniors more information.
Prom, again, it's a privilege. We want everyone to participate every year. Mm-hmm. We go out of our way to try to make it so that everyone can participate. Ms. Riley does a great job in trying to keep the cost reasonable. I know other high schools where the prom tickets are double that now. So we really try to make it reasonable and work with you. However, if you are, you know, have behavioral issues, if your grades, attendance, there's lots of things that can result in you not having an opportunity to participate in prom. So please, again, that would be the last thing that we want to do. Please put us in a good position by finishing strong. That's always my theme with seniors, finish strong.
And the last thing that I have are the senior events. While the rest of the campus is testing, whether it's PSAT testing or STAR testing, the seniors have the opportunity to go on field trips. And we do fun things like the zoo, alley cats, and a few different things. But that does cost. We did present that to the seniors at the beginning of the year. They have until March 10th to pay for that. So that they have the opportunity, they're not having to do work here on campus during STAR testing. They get to go and enjoy the fact that they're a senior and have completed all of these items. So like I said, the deadline for that is March 10th. The deadline, or the early deadline for cap and gowns, is March 1st. So these things are coming up soon. We like to spread things out as much as we can, which is why we start giving this information out at the beginning of the school year as soon as we have it. And that's pretty much what we have for the seniors right now.
Yeah, again, if you have any questions, Ms. Riley is, and Ms. Constance, please see them. They do a phenomenal job of making sure you have your senior needs met. And again, man, this should be such like a great experience for you, your spring semester of your senior year. Make sure you don't procrastinate. Don't wait until the last minute. Go ahead and start talking to your parents about the finances that you need to set aside so that you can participate in everything, and make some priority list of what you need to do so that your senior spring semester is great. That's what we want it to be. We want you to be successful. We're excited to hear about your future plans after high school and graduation. It's the best day of the year.
It is.
It's always the best day of the year to get to see the smiles on families and your face as you walk across the stage. It's truly the best day of the year. We look forward to celebrating you and that moment. Make sure you're taking care of business. Until next time, thank you, Ms. Riley.
Yes, sir.
Go Raiders.
Bye.